Hey there, everyone. Cancer's one of the scariest things we can go through. In 2018, more than 9 million people died from the disease. But what if we told you it can be prevented with the help of vitamin D? Studies certainly suggest just that. According to experts, its ability to regulate cellular growth plays an important role in this process. Of course, this is merely the tip of the iceberg. In order to understand more on this, we'll have to first discuss how vitamin D can prevent the disease. Let's begin, shall we? How do you get cancer? This disease is triggered when your genes are damaged by radical substances known as carcinogens. Most of the time, these substances are present in molecules of tobacco smoke. Hey, they don't say cigarettes cause cancer for nothing. This is why we suggest you don't indulge in smoking. Of course, there are many other ways for carcinogens to enter your body. For example, if your body's been exposed to radiation, it can be fatal. Exposure to fine particulate matter could also be ruled as a cause. You're also at risk of getting cancer if it runs in the family. Some types of cancer are genetic. Even infections, if not treated at the right time, can lead to it. Now, you must be wondering, how does the damage caused by carcinogen develop into cancer? Well, the answer's a little complicated, so we'll break it down for you in the simplest way possible. Imagine that your body is a wall built around a settlement. There's no way to break into the other side of it. Intruders may try many different tactics, but they'll always fail, until one day, they figure out how to jump over the wall. Of course, they aren't foolish enough to steal from the houses inside the day they enter. Instead, they wait, biding their time for the perfect opportunity. An opportunity that can enable them to steal whatever they want without getting caught. These intruders are like carcinogens. They enter your body and wait, rarely affecting you right away. Even if they do, it's usually minor. The longer they stay in your body, the more damage they cause. Then suddenly you'll notice a small infection. If you're a smart person, you'll go to the doctor right away and get yourself checked. This infection will only grow, infecting anything and everything it can. By the time you realize how serious it actually is, it may be too late. Those carcinogens would have already started their work. This is how they develop into cancer, and where vitamin D comes to the rescue. What is vitamin D? While vitamin D is seen as a nutrient, one shouldn't forget that it's actually a prohormone. What's a prohormone? Well, they're substances that convert into hormones. Usually, these substances are made by the body. As a matter of fact, most of the vitamin D that you need is made inside your body. Your kidneys are responsible for most of this creation process. Of course, there are other sources like sunlight and certain types of food. Let's get to the million-dollar question. How does vitamin D reduce cancer? This is how it works. It all began when a study suggested that death rates for certain types of cancer were lower in the southern latitudes than those in the north. This caught the eye of some researchers who decided to investigate it further. After all, it was pretty fascinating to even think it was possible. When they started digging, they found out it was mainly because of vitamin D. Prolonged exposure to sunlight in the southern latitude increases its production. This discovery raised a few eyebrows. One experiment focused on mice who had cancer cells and tumors in their bodies. They found that vitamin D could either slow or prevent the development of cancer. It could regulate the growth and promote cellular differentiation. It could also decrease the growth of cancer cells. More importantly, it can also cause cell death. Who would have thought that vitamin D could kill cancer cells? Of course, this doesn't mean that it can prevent all types of cancer. We simply don't have enough data to make such a bold statement, but we do have enough information to confirm vitamin D can reduce the risk of certain types of cancer. This includes colorectal cancer, breast cancer, and prostate cancer. Colorectal cancer turned out to be the most significant. There were 9 studies conducted on it. The conclusion was that vitamin D did reduce the risk of this type of cancer. Before we continue, we made a video about foods that can cause cancer. Feel free to check it out, as it's always better to stay informed about these types of things. So now that we've told you about how vitamin D can help you avoid cancer, here are some sources of this incredible prohormone. Number 1. Milk. While it's one of the most well-known sources of calcium and protein, milk also contains vitamin D. Cow's milk in particular is very rich in vitamin D. This is why children are often advised to drink it. If you happen to be lactose intolerant, we wouldn't suggest you drink milk. In that case, we would suggest that you try our next pick. Number 2. Egg yolks. The white part of the egg is a rich source of protein, but the yolk contains fats and vitamin D. Of course, you still have to go out in the sun, yet egg yolks are a good thing to consume on a regular basis. This doesn't mean that there aren't any exceptions. People who are vegetarians or vegans may not like egg yolks or cow's milk. If you're one of them, the next source is for you. Number 3. Mushrooms. According to many experts, mushrooms contain more than 2,000 international units of vitamin D. That's more vitamin D than egg yolks and milk. Usually, cow's milk contains about 100 or 120 international units of vitamin D, whereas a regular egg yolk contains more than 30 international units of vitamin D. This is why we recommend you consume mushrooms on the regular. Just make sure to go with mushrooms that are naturally grown. Commercially grown mushrooms don't have the same amount of vitamin D in them. Similarly, mushrooms grown under ultraviolet light usually have more than 100 international units. So, if you really want to try mushrooms, try the ones that are naturally grown. Number 4. Orange juice. Orange is rich in vitamin C, but it also contains vitamin D. Considering that a lot of people around the world are lactose intolerant, they can all opt for having orange juice. Usually around 200 milliliters of orange juice contains about 100 international units. Additionally, oranges also contain antibacterial and antimicrobial properties that are good for the body. Apart from that, oranges are good for replenishing energy. On that note, check out our video 7 Signs of Vitamin D Deficiency. It'll also help you understand the signs that you lack vitamin D. Number 5. Fish. There are different types of fish that contain vitamin D. One thing common among all of them is that they contain a lot of oil. Specifically, cod liver oil can contain more than 400 international units. That's higher than the average egg yolk. Did you know that vitamin D can reduce the risk of cancer? Are you making sure that you consume vitamin D on a regular basis? Let us know in the comment section below. We would love to hear from you. Enjoyed this video? Hit like, share, and subscribe to Bestie. Wait! What kind of bestie would we be if we didn't tell you about our other awesome videos? Go ahead, choose the left or right video and enjoy.